Hello dear students, today we'll discuss about the lipsticks. As you know that lipsticks are the very demanding product, specifically for the women's and the girls also. Without the lipsticks, you can say that makeup is not completed, and it is always a charm for the girls as well as the ladies to use these lipsticks of various sets. I will discuss about this in detail. This chapter or this part of this B Pharma fifth semester subject industrial pharmacy, which will be covered under unit 5. So the various points to be discussed during this lecture are definition of the lipsticks, what are the various characteristics of the lipsticks, composition, formulation related problems, molding related problems, evolution of finished products, and few of the marketed products. So as you can define that it is also called as the lip cosmetics, widely used by the women. It may be referred as color cosmetics. Lipstick is a cosmetic product containing pigments, oils, waxes, and emollients that applies color and texture to the lips. There are many varieties of the lipsticks, and as far as concern this, the earlier historical name of the lipsticks is, it is known as the lippy in the British world. What are the various characteristics which should possess in the lipstick? It should have cover lips adequately. It should be long last effect. It should make lips soft. It must adhere firmly to lips without being brittle and tacky. Good degree of quality, completely free from grittiness. It should be non-drying. It should be non-irritating to skin of the lips. The desirable degree of the plasticity should be there in that product. It should have high retention of colors intensity without any change in the shades. The pleasant odor and the flavor, free from sweating, shiny and smooth appearance, easily applicable and removable, and stable both in physical as well as in the chemical form. The composition of the lipsticks are shown in the slide. These are wax mixture, oil mixture, bromo mixture, colors, preservatives, fragrance, antioxidants, surfactants, and the other additives are being used in this lipstick preparation. The various waxes which are being used in this product, they provide the gloss and the hardness. These are the generally depends on the characteristics and the quantity of the waxes which are being used by you. The best characteristic is obtained by using mixture of the waxes, means that you have to use two different waxes so that you can achieve the optimum or the desirable glossy as well as the hardness in that product. And it should, that one more characteristic should be there, these waxes should have the different melting point, and it should be adjusted to the final melting point by incorporating a sufficient amount of the high melting point wax. The various waxes which are being used in the lipsticks are cetosterol alcohol. It is being used apart from that cetyl alcohol, sericin wax, white beeswax, candelilla wax, carnauba wax, hard paraffin, soft paraffin. These have the various these melting points. It is between 38 to 88 degrees centigrade. And the various purposes of using these waxes are, it can be used for the emollient purpose, which provides the removal or the it provides the dehydration. I mean to say that it keeps water retained in that product, it is the quality of that product that retains the water amount in the applied part. Apart from that, these sericin wax can be used to increase the melting point. White beeswax are being used as a binding of oils and the higher melting point waxes. The candelilla wax, the purpose of using this is to give smooth and the glossy appearance. And other waxes are there which imparts a rigidity and the hardness, improves glossiness, and can work as a lubricant and increase the spreadability of the product. The various oils which are being used are like that, and the purpose of the using the oils, especially in the mixture, is required to blend properly with the waxes to provide a suitable film on the applied lip skin. Oils are also acts as solvent in some formulations. They are also acting as a dispersing agent for insoluble pigments. The ideal mixture of oils should produce the product easily spreadable and produce a thin film with good covering power. Means that this is the main characteristic of the lipstick, that it should be uniformly distributed or uniformly spread on the application part, like lips. The various oils which are being used are castor oil, tetrahydrofurfuryl alcohol and the esters, fatty acid alkylamides, paraffin oil, isopropyl myristate, isopropyl palmitate and butyl stearates. Another composition of this lipstick is the bromo mixtures. They are being used to maintain the physical form of the formulation, also called as the bromo acids. There are available two classes. One is providing the red color, gives red or the reddish blue tints, and another one is provides orange red that gives pink to yellowish pink tint. About the bromo mixture should be used about 2 to 3% in the lipsticks, and the solvents which are being used to mix with the bromo acids, like castor oil and the butyl stearates, THFA, esters like acetate stearate and the benzoates, glyceryl monostearate or the monolaurate, and diethylene glycol monostearates or propylene glycol or polyethylene glycols. Here is the examples of the bromo mixtures are being given. The bromo acid, it should be used around 15 grams. That PG is 200 gram and the PG monomyristate is about 100 gram. The procedure to make this, you have to mix the bromo acid solution and the propylene glycol, add PG monostearate into it, which gives bromo acid that easily mixes with the mineral oil and castor oil and produces a homogeneous mass with waxes. Apart from that, colors are being used to give the various sets in that product. The most important from commercial and the appearance point of view, it is very lucrative that which sort of shade is required in that product. In the older days, when this carmine was widely used, but nowadays various other colors are also available. Colors in the lipstick is simply imparted by two ways: by staining the skin with solution of dye stuff, which can penetrate the outer layer of the skin. These are the soluble dyes, and the other which are being used by covering the lips with a colored layer, which serves to hide any skin roughness and give a smooth appearance, are being used or can be achieved by the insoluble dyes. The soluble dyes or the staining dyes are examples for this are the fluorescein dyes and the eosin dye. And for the insoluble dyes, the examples are lacs of calcium, barium, aluminium, strontium. And this must be used between 10 to 15% concentration based on the shade desired. Titanium dioxide is generally used in the concentration of the 1% for pink, obtaining pink shade. Apart from colors, the preservatives are also being used to give the stability to the product. And they also used to prevent the microbial growth. And for the purpose, you can say that propyl para hydroxy benzoate in 0.1% quantity can be used as a preservative. The higher concentration of the preservative cannot be used. If you are using the higher concentration of these preservatives, that may lead to the slightly burning sensation or the allergic reaction at the application part. Another ingredient which is being used in the lipsticks are the fragrance. This is essential component of the lipstick. It is used to mask bad odor of fatty or the waxes which is being used in the product. It is used to impart attractive flavor. The concentration which is being used, generally it is between 2 to 4%, and while selecting the fragrance, that ingredient should have the qualities like that free from irritating effect, it should free from the disagreeable taste, and it must be stable and the compatible with other ingredients. Antioxidants can also be used, and it is being used in the products to prevent the rancidification of the oily bases during the storage. Rancidification is a major problem where we are using the oily bases or the waxes, and that may lead to the hydroxylation or the oxidation. That is the reason for the rancidification of that product. It is generally used in the combination. The examples of these antioxidants are the BHA, BHT, propyl gallate, and the citric acids. Apart from that, surfactants and the other additives are being also used. The surfactants generally used to promote the wetting and to stabilize the dispersion of the insoluble pigments in lipstick bases. Additives which are being used for the various purposes like oil, soluble sunscreen. This gives you the this filters the sun rays and protect lip skin from sunburn. Silicone fluid can also be used as a fixative and prevent colors from bleeding on the lips. Polyvinyl pyrrolidone in the concentration of 0.5 to 1% can be used to film former on the lips and reduce the allergic reaction of other ingredients in the lipsticks. Isopropyl linoleate, this prevents drying effect of that product. And this is a formula given generally that contains in the lipsticks, that is Carnauba wax, lanolin, cetyl alcohol, castor oil, bromoacid, color pigments, perfume, beeswax, and the percentage which can be used are given against them. Now coming to the general manufacturing process of the lipsticks, it is very basic and involves the three steps only. This is just to melt the waxes and mix it well, and mix it well all the ingredients which are being used, and then all that solution is being kept in the molds, and after that freezing of that molds, that when this product is getting deposited or freezed, or that you can say that get solidified, then you can take out that product and can be sent further for the labeling as well as for the packaging purpose. Generally, when you are preparing or when you are dealing with the lipsticks during the manufacturing, there are certain problems may arise in or may arise that may be to the relation to the formulation, as well as that may be related to the mold. Coming to the formulated related problems or the defects, they are sweating, bleeding, blooming, streaking, and seams. As well as if we discuss about the mold related problems or the defects, that is laddering, deformation, cratering, and the mushy failure. The formulation related problems like sweating, it is the most common problem which we are facing in the product. First, due to the high oil content or inferior oil blending capacity of the wax composition, it may arise in any climate or the temperature range or the change in the temperature that may lead to the sweating of that product. Next problem is formulation problem is the bleeding of that product. It is the separation of the colored liquids from the waxy base. It leads to extremely uneven color distribution when it is being applied. So that is the bleeding is there. Another problem is blooming. When the surface of the lipstick appears dull instead of desired gloss is called as the problem of the blooming. It is chiefly due to the higher percentage of the cetyl alcohol, that is more than 5% when you are using, that may lead to the blooming in that product. Streaking is another formulation related problem. It is a thin line or a band of different color or the substance appears to the surface of finished products. This problem arises due to the separation of the suspended particles. Now coming to the seams. This marks the left on the lipsticks when split molds are used. They are caused either due to the brittle masses or due to the faulty cooling technique. The laddering, it is the molding related problem. In this defect, the product has a ladder like appearance. I mean to say that you can see in the picture that ladders like development in the product, you will see that it does not look smooth or homogeneous after congealing and setting, but instead a multi-layered appearance is observed in that. This is occurred due to the either mold is kept at a very low temperature or when bulk formulation is hot enough or filling rate is slow. Deformation is another molding related problem. As you can see in the picture that it is showing that there is a change in the shape of that product. The shape of the lipstick looks deformed. It is changed. It is most noticeable in softer formulas It can be appear on side of the lipstick or on both the sides. The cattering is another molding related problem. This effect is mostly found in split moldings. As you can see here that the dimples, your spots are developed in that product. You can see in this picture that this is, it shows up in flaming when the stick develops dimples like. The main cause is the presence of trace amounts of silicone oils or machinery lubrication oil from manufacturing mixtures or the dispenser mixtures. This is another molding related problem, that is mushy failure. When the central core of the stick lacks structure and breaks, then this mushy failure is noted. The problem is not related to the particular formula or particular shed. This is the granularity caused by the carnauba wax. This is the known reason that that may lead to the development of the mushy failure in that product. Now coming to the evaluation part of the finished product, the various parameters which are being considered for the evaluation of the lipstick product are color control, determination of the melting point, softening point, microbial testing, rancidity, rupture test, breaking load test. The color control is the main parameter for the evaluation. The color control of the lipstick is critical, and one only has to see the range of colors available from a manufacturer to be aware of this. The dispersion of the pigment is checked stringently when a new batch is manufactured, and the color must be carefully controlled when the lipstick mask is reheated. Colorimetric equipments are being used to provide some control on the sheds of the lipstick. This equipment gives a numerical reading of the shed when mixed, so it can identically match previous batches. I mean to say that the standard readings are there, and on the using this equipment, colorimetric equipments, you can see that at which scale it is coming, and when it is reaching or when it is achieving the predefined specification of that product of the company, then it can be further sent for the production of that once you achieve this. This equipment gives a numerical reading of the set when mixed, so it can identically match previous batches. Matching of reheated batches is done visually. So there must be care must be taken at that time, and environmental control should also be observed. And this when it is not immediately used in that condition, that you can keep a watch for that. The next evaluation parameter is the determination of the melting point. Here you can see that an apparatus is being shown in this picture where you can make the arrangements. Generally that this process involves that the lipstick base should have a melting point between 55 to 75 degrees centigrade. The method which you followed for the determination of the melting points, that is that you had to take the sample around 50 milligrams, melt and fill into the glass capillary tube open on both the ends, as you can see in the picture. Then cool the capillary tube with ice for 2 hours, fasten the capillary tube to a thermometer, place a beaker full of water on a heating plate with a magnetic stirrer, start heating and stirring at slow and the fixed speed. Then the temperature at which the material moves along the capillary tube is considered its melting point. The next evaluation parameter is the softening point of that product. A lipstick should withstand the range of conditions to which it will subjected in the consumer's handbag. I mean, it should not be softened when you are keeping in the purse, or the ultimate consumer which are being using this product, it should withstand with this evaluation parameter. It should be resistant to varying temperature and be just as easy to apply in the hot as in the cold weather. There should not be the variation that if you are using that in the winter season, it is not giving the proper result, and if you are using in the summer season, it is not giving you the desired effect. So that the product should match both the conditions, and it can be equally used or uniformly used in any condition. The softening point ranges between the 50 to 55 degrees centigrade. This can be determined by using the ring and the ball method or any other method. The ring and ball method is that you can see here in the picture that the ring or the support orifice is taken and the lipstick to be tested is inserted into it. The extra mass above and below the orifice is removed using a sharp blade, leaving a tablet of lipstick fitted into the ring. This is placed in refrigerated for about refrigerated condition, say about 6 degrees centigrade for about 10 minutes, and then a ring is tied on a stand or bar. Then a beaker containing 500 ml water at room temperature is placed on a hot plate having a magnetic stirrer. Then the steel ball is delicately placed on the lipstick tablet. The bar is with support is then inserted into the beaker till it submerges into it. Heating and the slow agitation is then begun. Temperature is monitored using a thermometer. Then the temperature at which the lipstick mass and the steel balls are loosened and falls to the bottom of the beaker is the softening point. The softening point can also be determined by another method. In this method, that whole lipstick along with its stand is kept in a long flat bottom tube. You must take care when the lipstick is in the protruded position and the bulb of the thermometer just touches the lipstick mass. Place this setup in 1 liter beaker filled with water to a level 1 centimeter above the upper above the protruding lipstick. Start heating water very slowly at the rate of 1 to 2 degrees centigrade per minute. The temperature at which the lipstick start bending and deforming from its shape is the softening point. Apart from that, microbial testing is also required for the evaluation of the lipstick product. And there are the chances that contamination can be there from the raw materials or the molds or the storage kettles or lipstick container, which can lead to the microbial growth. The microbial testing is suggested as per the Indian standard mentioned in the 9875 of the 1990. The test consists of plating a known mass of the sample on two selected culture media, especially suitable for the growth of the bacteria and the fungi, and incubating them for a specified period to permit the development of visual colonies for counting. The limit should not be more than 100 micro per gram. Another parameter, which is rancidity. This rancidification is the decomposition of the fats, oils, and other lipids by hydrolysis or by the oxidation. If the oxidation of the castor oil or other waxy or lipoidal ingredients takes place in that condition, that leads to the obnoxious odor, bad taste, sticky product, and sometimes change of color of the product. The testing of the rancidity can be done by determining its peroxide number. Another parameter is the breaking load test. As you can see in the picture, that the test is to find out the value of the maximum load that a lipstick can withstand before it breaks. The protruded lipstick swell is subjected to a number of weights hanging from it. As you can see, that the weight at which the lipstick breaks is its breaking point. You can see that lipstick is being kept and the weight is put on that one, and it is increased as per that the process. And when this lipstick breaks, this is known as the breaking load test. That weights can be replaced by using the increasing increments of water from a burette also. Another evaluation parameter is the rupture test. In the rupture test, the lipstick is placed in two holders in the extended position. Then weight is added to the holder on the lipstick portion at 30 seconds intervals until the lipstick ruptures. The pressure required to rupture the lipstick is then checked against the manufacturer's standards. Since there are no industry standards for these tests, each manufacturer set its own parameters. Thank you.